A few moments ago, the inauguration of Donald Trump. And quite frankly, I'm not concerned about Donald Trump. He's in the White House now. You're hardly going to see him. But the fact, the Islamophobia, which Donald Trump based his campaign on, and he was able to sell it to Americans who voted him in. This is my concern. What I'm trying to say, brothers and sisters in Islam, over 50% of America believed in what Donald Trump had to say about Islam and Muslims. We know that this is not true. But what I'm trying to say is we have a lot of work to do, not with Donald Trump, but I'm talking about Patricia and John, Alex, and so on, with whom you interact. And they believe in what Donald Trump had to say about you. What are you going to do? What is your plan? Do you have a plan? This is my message, brothers and sisters in Islam. I'm talking about developing a good character. Look, Egypt was not a Muslim land like America. Yusuf came from a Muslim land. Yusuf spread Islam in Egypt, one man show. But through what? His character, his nobility. Listen, it's easy to lose one's temper. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the strong person is not the one who yells loud. Even in gang language, they say the weakest person in the gang is the loudest. The guy, but the strong is the one who hardly speaks. But the strong one is the one who is able to control himself when angry. This is what we need to do in America to change, to win the hearts and minds and souls again. Not of Donald Trump. The only one who can change Donald Trump is Allah now. Because power is a fitna. Only Allah, we can ask Allah to change his heart. But I'm talking about your co-workers. I'm talking about your colleagues. I'm talking about anyone you interact with. You have a challenge. How to let them have a good perspective about Islam and Muslims, a good impression about us. And this will help our life in America in general. And brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm not asking you to do something that was not done before. This was the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam too. When Abi Dharr al-Ghifari radiyallahu anhu learned that there is a man in Mecca who claims to be a messenger, so he called upon his brother Unais. He said, "Ya Unais, there is a man in Mecca called Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam who's claiming to be a prophet, a messenger. Go and check him out." Unais went to Mecca. Pay attention, Mecca, not Medina. Mecca, we know the 10 years of oppression, the 10 years of the top of the line of Islamophobia. I'm not talking about Donald Trump. I'm talking about Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, top of the line. Physical attacks, psychological attacks. Unais, by the way, went to Mecca, kept an eye on Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam like a civilian's camera. And at the end, he went to his brother and he submitted a report made of one sentence. You know what is written in that report? I saw a man who's commanding good character. Good character. If each Muslim in America can change one American's perspective about this deen, about this religion, you will see what will happen. I'm telling you, this is the best time to give da'wah in America and in the West. This is the best time to talk about Islam, but not with the tongue, through your character, through your smile, your positivity.